Hi, church family. It's Pastor Lauren here, and I just wanted to say good morning and happy Mother's Day to all of you amazing mothers out there. Mothers, grandmas, aunties, we love you so much and honor you and celebrate you on this special day. Hope you all are doing well. We are officially in day 60 of our quarantine, which is crazy and hard to believe. Hope you all are staying healthy and well. I just wanted to come in and give a few announcements to start off our morning. So first, I wanted to tell you about our prayer meetings. So we've had prayer meetings every other Wednesday for the past few weeks, and it was so wonderful because last time we were able to hear from the Mizukis, who were able to Zoom with us all the way from Japan. And it was so great to hear the voices of Paul and Rie, and we even got a home tour of where they're staying. And so I'll insert some clips here.
Recording this too.
The faucet here has only cold water, and then if you want hot water, you have to put this on, and then the gas comes on and it heats the water and it comes out.
This refrigerator, here's the refrigerator, here's the freezer. There's a sensor section here, and we still don't know, you know, whether it's colder, warmer, what it is. And then we've got all the storage here. And then this is the room that we're sleeping in, which is the biggest room in the house.
So Mizukis, if you're watching this, we love you, we're praying for you, and for our congregation, I hope that you can remember, if you signed up on our Google Doc on your day to pray, to remind you to keep doing that, keeping prayer warriors for our world, our church, and the Mizukis. And our next announcement, I wanted to talk about an exciting series that we're going to go into the weekend after Mother's Day. And so this series, we actually bumped it up a little bit and our staff met and we were talking about what shall we do for our next series. And usually, you all know, we have a summer movie series, but we decided because in light of COVID-19 and quarantine and being safer at home, we thought it would be fun to bump up the summer movie series right now. And so I'll be kicking it off and starting off the first movie with The Farewell. And if you remember last year, I did Crazy Rich Asians, and so it actually has one of the same actors in it. So Awkwafina, who plays Piglin in Crazy Rich Asians, is actually the main actress in The Farewell. And so it's a really heartwarming, but also heart-wrenching story that has to do with culture, Asian American, actually Chinese culture too. And so we wanted to dive into that. So you can tune in to that movie. Hope you can watch it before next Sunday. And actually, right now it's perfect timing. It's free on Amazon Prime, if you have Amazon Prime, so make sure to watch it. Just a few weeks ago, it was $5, so hope you guys could get it for free. The second movie that we'll be doing is A Beautiful Day in the Neighborhood, and Pastor Kristen's going to be doing this one, and it's based off of Mr. Rogers' life. The third movie we'll be doing is by Pastor Matt, and he will be going over Wreck-It Ralph, which should be really fun. And then our fourth movie in this summer movie series is going to be by Pastor Kevin, and he's going to be doing Two Popes. And as we do announcements in the future, we'll be saying just where you can find these movies, where you could rent them, and hope that helps. And our last announcement is that we have something very special for you all, and it's a video commemorating all of the amazing, incredible women that are at Anaheim Free Methodist Church. And so the following compilation of pictures, actually has our first service, second service, and Nichigo. Moms, grandmas, and aunties. And just wanted to deeply thank Jerry and Lisa Wada for putting this together, and for some of you for contributing some photos. But as we go into this time of worship, I pray that seeing the faces of Anaheim can be a sense of worship as we just remember our own mothers, as we remember the spiritual mothers or motherly figures that have been in our lives, that have made such a difference and really molded us to be the people we are today. And so as you watch this video, keep that in mind, and I pray that you can really live today with a sense of gratitude and a sense of thankfulness. So take a look at this. Heartwarming. One thing that I've really been enjoying is seeing pictures of all of your faces, or seeing your faces over Zoom, like right now on the live stream. And so if you're with us, thank you so much for tuning in. It's been such a blessing to be in breakout sessions with all of you and to get to know our congregation more on a personal level. It's been such a neat gift to be able to see all of your faces, especially since this quarantine, we're not able to meet in person. But church, with that, I hope you're encouraged, and I hope you can hug your mom tight today and just tell her thank you for all that she's done for you. And if this is maybe your first Mother's Day without your mom, or your mom has been gone for a while now, I just want you to know that the Lord is near, and He is your Emmanuel, and He is with you, and He sees your heart, and He sees your pain. He also just says, I love you, and I'm with you. And so I pray that you can hold tight to whether it's the memories, or hold tight to just your mom right now in person. And if you're able to do that, you're just so blessed, and I hope you can know that. And with that, let's go to the Lord in prayer as we transition into worship. Lord Jesus, we thank you so much for your presence. God, we thank you so much for the gift that is mothers. Lord, we pray right now that you could invade our space, that if we're watching this service in our living room or our kitchen or our office, that you would make your face known, that you would make your heart known to us. That, Lord, we would be open to your Holy Spirit, and that we could know that you reside not just at church in the chapel, but you reside here within us right now. So Lord, I pray that during this time, as we listen to Pastor Matt lead us in worship and listen to Pastor Kevin lead us in the sermon and your word, that we could have open eyes and open ears to be receptive to your teaching and be receptive to your heart. So thank you, Jesus, for all that you do, and we continue to ask for your healing and restorative work in our lives and in this world. We love you, Jesus, and pray all of these things in your holy and precious name. Amen.
Well, as I'm sure you've heard many times today, happy Mother's Day. It is so wonderful to be here to worship with you, to give thanks to God who has given us all these wonderful motherly figures in our life who have drawn us closer to the Lord, that have spoken into our lives, spoken truth, spoken formation, and have created us to be who we are today. So we give thanks to you, all the mothers out there, all the women who have impacted our lives. Today we're going to start off our service by singing a few songs of praise to our Lord. So if you're able to stand, I'm going to invite you to stand with us, and we're going to start off our service by singing the song, Blessed Be Your Name. Blessed be your name.
Blessed be your name in a land that is plentiful, where streams of abundance flow. Blessed be your name. Blessed be your name when I'm found in the desert place, where I walk through the wilderness. Blessed be your name.
Every blessing.
Every blessing you pour out, I'll turn back to praise. When the darkness closes in, Lord, still I will say, blessed be your name of the Lord. Blessed be your name. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be your glorious name.
Blessed be.
Blessed be your name. When the sun's shining down on me, when the world's all as it should be, blessed be your name. Blessed be your name. On the road marked with suffering, there's pain in the offering, blessed be your name. Every blessing you pour out, I'll turn back to praise. When the darkness closes in, Lord, still I will say, blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be your name. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be your glorious name.
See that bridge you give and take?
You give and take away. You give and take away. Heart will choose to say, Lord, blessed be your name. You give and take away. You give and take away. My heart will choose to say, Lord, blessed be your name. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be your name. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be your glorious name.
Just take a moment right now just to give thanks to God in your own words. In your own prayers, just lift them up in your own houses right now. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. You're so, so good. Sing these words with me. Sing, you give life and you give love.
You give life. You are love, you bring light to the darkness, you give hope, you restore every heart that is broken. Great are you, Lord.
It's your breath,
it's your breath. Our lungs, so we pour out our praise. We pour out our praise. It's your breath in our lungs, so we pour out our praise to you only.
Top, sing, you give life.
You give life. You are love. You bring light to the darkness. You give hope. You restore every heart that is broken. Great are you, Lord. It's your breath in our lungs. So we pour out our praise. We pour out our praise. It's your breath in our lungs. So we pour out our praise to you. It's your breath in our lungs. So we pour out our praise. We pour out our praise. It's your breath in our lungs. So we pour out our praise to you only.
Sing that bridge with me, church. Sing, all the earth will shout your praise.
All the earth will shout your praise. Our hearts will cry. These bones will sing. Great are you, Lord. All the earth will shout your praise. Our hearts will cry. These bones will sing, great are you, Lord. All the earth will shout your praise. Our hearts will cry. These bones will sing, great are you. All the earth will shout your praise. Our hearts will cry. These bones will sing. Great are you, Lord. It's your breath in our lungs. So we pour out our praise. Pour out our praise. Your breath in our lungs, so we pour out our praise to you only. Your breath in our lungs, so we pour out our praise. Pour out our praise. It's your breath in our lungs, so we pour out our praise to you only.
Father, we thank you for your goodness, for the ways in which you draw close to us, how we can feel your presence and your spirit moving amongst us, even though we are apart, God. You're moving in our homes. You're moving in our families. God, you're speaking to us. So, Father, we come here this morning awaiting your word, awaiting for your invitation for us. And God, we are here and we are receptive to your voice. God, we love you so much. We pray all these things in your name. Amen. Amen. Well, at this time, feel free to pause the video to grab yourself a snack. And when you're ready, we're going to hear the word given to us by Pastor Kevin. I'll see you in a little bit.
Hey, church family. Just want to say a happy Mother's Day to all the mothers and grandmothers out there. We want to really celebrate you. We hope you enjoyed that video. Also today, we are closing out our series called Awake, O Sleeper. But before we get into that, I did want to give you some news of some exciting things coming up with our new sermon videos. Starting next week, we're going to be starting what we've called the Quarantine Movie Series, since so many of you are now at home and you have more time, and maybe like me, you've been watching a lot more Netflix or Amazon Prime Video. Movies and TV. We're kind of moving up our summer movie series, and we're going to start it next Sunday. So Pastor Lauren's going to be speaking on the film The Farewell, And then after that, Pastor Kristen will be speaking on the movie that's about Mr. Rogers called A Beautiful Day in the Neighborhood. Then Pastor Matt will be speaking about Wreck-It Ralph. And then I will close out that series by speaking on The Two Popes, which feature Anthony Hopkins and Jonathan Pryce. Well, I hope you'll watch those films, as you can see some of them, not all of them, on Netflix or Amazon Prime Video. So this week, your homework is to watch The Farewell, starring Awkwafina. It's actually on Amazon Prime Video. So if you have Amazon Prime, you can actually watch it for free. And hope you can watch it this week, maybe with your life group, your growth group, or just at home. Get out your popcorn. You could watch it any time of the day now. And hope you'll enjoy that film, and we'll pull out some of the spiritual truth, biblical truth, and how it pertains to our relationship with the Lord and the world. So today, we're closing out our series called Awake, O Sleeper, which is a reference to the verse from Ephesians 5:14, I believe, which says, "Awake, wake up, O sleeper, rise from the dead, and Christ will shine on you." And so this was a passage that really had spoken to me specifically during this time, during the pandemic, during this time in quarantine. And a lot of it was because I felt like this was a moment where God and the Holy Spirit was calling not just us individually, but all of humanity to, literally the world has come to a pause. Financial markets, business as usual had been stopped and halted. And in many ways we were left to think about life, to think about our fears, our dreams, about our family, our relationships. And so this is a point where, as I think states and countries are starting to reopen, this is a very opportune time where I wonder, what were the things and what are the things that God has been trying to awaken in you? And I think for me, at least, it's been a lot of rethinking, reevaluating what life was like before the pandemic, which feels like a long time ago, but really trying to rethink, realign ourselves with where God may be taking us in the near future. And so before we get into my text for the day, I wanted to reread what Pastor Matt was speaking on last Sunday, and that's in verse 15, which gives us a real good introduction to the end of the series, which goes from verses 17 through 21. But in Ephesians 5:15, Paul writes this, and he says, "Be very careful then how you live." Be very careful how you live. And what you need to understand is Paul, throughout the whole book of Ephesians to this point, there are many points along the way where he is actually referring to God's saving plan for each person. And in light of knowing that he sent Jesus to be the saving force and the healing force in the world, knowing what God's big picture, his ultimate goal, his ultimate plan was, Paul is saying these words, knowing God's saving plan, you should be careful then how you live. And so another way that this is translated in the Greek, a good way that I think we can understand this is, be careful then how you walk. Be careful how you walk. In other words, be very mindful of how you are living your life. Be mindful of what acts you are taking place in, what your thoughts are, your behavior. Be careful how you are walking out your walk, how you're living out your walk. And then he says, right after that, not as unwise, but as wise. And so Paul is referring back to all of this Old Testament wisdom. If you know the Bible, if you know Old Testament, what he's actually referring almost to like the book of Proverbs, where there's this contrast between the people who are wise do this, and the people who are foolish or who fall into folly do this. And what an underlying idea of what Paul is saying here is that the people who understand, who know God's saving plan, his overarching plan for everybody, the foolish are the people who are not living in that way. They are living life for their own ends. And so I would say, for my interpretation of this, is for the people who are in the pandemic and the quarantine, those are the people who are, they're just trying to make it through. They're just trying to survive. They're just trying to get through this to see what's going to be like after. But I really believe, I firmly believe, this is a very a moment where the Lord really is trying to say something. And I think if we're honest, a lot of us have actually experienced a lot of difficulties, a lot of struggle, a lot of stress, a lot of lack of control. You know, I know for those of you who have been living with your family or your parents or your children, and you've been having to like work out a lot of relational tension or a lot of relational dynamics, I think God's trying to say something there. For those of us who live alone, like myself, what is God saying to us in our solitude, in many ways in our silence? And so these are the places, these are the moments where I think God is trying to awaken us, parts of us within us that may have been dead, maybe parts of us that we didn't know really existed before. I think one of the funny ways that many of you have found life is in these different hobbies, all these activities that you didn't do before the pandemic. I know many of you are doing some gardening. I know a lot of people all over are making bread. I don't know why these hobbies happen, but for other reasons, I think people have found life outside of the busyness and the hustle bustle. And so even in my moments of extreme just mental fatigue, or even feeling like this is never gonna end, one thing that God's really awakened me towards is just enjoying the small things of the day. Just this morning, as I was making my coffee, I looked outside my window and I noticed this butterfly, a monarch butterfly, that was flying around. And the Lord's just really been speaking to me in the small moments of having great gratefulness and gratitude in those moments. Another day this week, I was just kind of stuck inside my house, felt like I was in prison, and just, you know, stuck with my thoughts and my feelings. And then I happened to go outside and I noticed that there was a sunset. And this was a moment that I probably would not have had before the pandemic. But the Lord has just been slowing life down for me. And rather trying to cram multiple thousands of things in a small amount of time, he's allowed me to just focus on a few things and focus on them to the full. So the passage goes on, and the passage for today is verses 17 through 21. And Paul says, "Therefore, do not be foolish, but understand what the Lord's will is. Do not get drunk on wine, which leads to debauchery. Instead, be filled with the Spirit." And so Paul is actually contrasting, when you are drunk on wine, you are drunk on alcohol, with contrasting that with almost in a way being like drunk with the Holy Spirit, being filled with the Holy Spirit. And so the teaching for us today is, in order to awaken ourselves fully, we need to be obviously be filled with the Spirit. In a way, we need to be drunk with the Holy Spirit. Forgive that metaphor, but that is in a way what Paul is really getting on. One of the actions of the foolish, of those who don't understand God's saving plan, is they fill their life, they'll fill their time of darkness with self-medication, with addictions, with joy and pleasure to its full. And not that drinking wine or drinking the occasional drink is a bad or is a sin, but he's comparing that with what it means to be filled with the Spirit. And the beautiful thing about what Paul writes is he actually gives us four ways to be filled with the Spirit. And so what I want to do is break up those four pieces and explain to you what Paul is really trying to say as we become more and more filled with the Spirit, especially in this time. And so I hope for you, the question isn't how will you be after quarantine ends. The question will be, you will be changed somehow after quarantine ends. The question is, will you be a more evolved version of yourself or a more devolved person version of yourself? And so I want all of us, I hope all of us are coming awakened, a new being, a new creation, a new lens, a new perspective. Maybe God's moving in you into the best season of your life, potentially. And so Paul gives us really great, practical, specific instruction for how to be filled with the Spirit. So the first way that Paul encourages us to be filled with the Spirit is in verse 19, which says, "Speak to one another with psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs." What Paul is actually saying here is to sing songs to one another and make music. I think a practical application for us today is knowing that we can sing songs, we can sing worship songs, and we can do this individually, we can do this privately now. We don't need to do this in public on a Sunday service. But one of the ways that we can be filled with the Spirit is not only singing songs to Jesus, but maybe even sharing songs or singing songs to other people. If you are actually here on the Zoom watch party, would you do me a favor and just go to the chat box and just start sharing maybe worship songs that have been speaking to you during this time. Share your favorite psalm or psalms that have been speaking to you. Just do that right now in the Zoom box or Zoom chat box. Or if you're at home, you can also just write those down. And maybe you, right now you'd want to text that or email that to somebody. But there's really this horizontal relationship that Paul is getting at here, that we need to speak to one another. And there's a verse in Colossians that almost talks about kind of teaching and instructing us, reminding ourselves of the importance of musical worship. And so an underlying theme to this whole idea of being filled with the Spirit is asking the question, you know, how is your worship? How is your worship from your heart coming out right now in this time? I know this is always a good test of where my soul or where my heart is, you know, when we were gathering at church and I'm sitting in service in the chapel, and a good heart check for me was always, how much am I into the worship time? Have I been just mouthing the words? Am I just sitting in my thoughts and my worries, or am I actually singing? Because that actually ties to the second thing that Paul gives us to be filled with the Spirit, is to sing and make music in your heart to the Lord. Sing and make music in your heart to the Lord. Another way to read that or hear that is your whole being should be in singing to the Lord. And that's why this is such a good heart check for me is am I actually singing these words, these hymns, these psalms, these worship songs? Are they actually coming from the depth of my soul, my heart? Or am I just singing them because they're a catchy tune, because I'm familiar with it for all these years? The third way that Paul gives us, instructs us to be filled with the Spirit is he says in verse 20, he says, "Always give thanks to God, the Father, for everything in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ." And I want to show you real quick just the way that this is structured. I'll show you, hopefully there'll be a slide that comes up, which shows us that we should give thanks to God the Father for everything in the name of the Father, the Lord Jesus Christ. And another word that is included in that is always or constantly. Always to God the Father for everything in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. And so that may be a very important practice for us. I know one practice that has actually helped me to keep my head afloat above the water is at the end of the day, really just reflecting on what are the things that I was grateful for during the day. And they could be something really small. It could be something really minute, but what were the ways and the things that I was grateful to the Lord for, whether it was the butterfly or the sunset, What are the ways? That is a time for us to incorporate into our rule of life. If you've been doing a rule of life, this can be an important thing of incorporating the practice of gratitude, the spiritual practice of examine. These are ways that we can continually make sure that we're being filled with the Spirit. The final and the fourth way that Paul gives us to be filled with the Spirit, and this may be very practical for those of you who are actually at home living with your family or living with other people, is that Paul gives us an instruction to submit to one another out of reverence for Christ. Submit to one another out of reverence for Christ. And so a very key teaching that Paul gives us over and over and over is this idea, this concept of mutual submission. And this is in great contrast to the way that most or other relationships come, where it's a hierarchy and there's, you know, a master and a slave, or a boss and employee. What Paul is instructing to us, especially those who are in tight-knit communities, is that we have to learn to submit to one another. And what that means is, in many ways, is that there are times when we may need to not forego our own needs, but it might be just getting ourselves outside of what our needs are or the voids that are happening in our life. But it's really about seeing the needs of other people. And where is the other person coming from? What is their need that may be causing them to react, to respond this way? And in a self-sacrificial way, trying to work that out from a position of coming from an equal ground, not from a place of I'm the authority or I'm over you, my needs are more important than you. And this is a teaching that Paul gives us, that a way that we can be filled with the Spirit. And so he says to speak one another with psalms and hymns and songs. He says, sing, give thanks, and remember to submit to one another out of reverence for Christ. Because ultimately, it was Jesus who actually came down. And he's the one who actually made us equal to him in some forms. He came to our level out of reverence for Christ, who became human. He brought himself down. And he has led us, and he's taught us, and he's instructed us, not completely from a hierarchical relationship. But if you notice, Jesus's primary model of leadership was one that was a leader among equals, a leader among equals. And so I hope that teaching would soak into your heart, soak into your soul. It's a lot to chew on. It's a lot to think about. But I hope that you would go to these four places, these four instructions, and that you may be filled with the Spirit, and that your whole heart, your whole being, will, your integrated self will be awakened and full when this quarantine is over. Let me pray. Lord, we're just thankful for just the power of your word and these words from Paul that inspire us to not be filled with the things of this world, but Lord, that you offer us fullness and spiritual maturity by following your teaching. Lord, would you help us to be just aware of the needs of others, but also be aware of our needs, knowing that it's not about just forgetting about our needs and doing things for other people. But Lord, it might just be about having a different perspective, seeing things a different way. And Lord, most of all, we just pray that your Holy Spirit would be the guide. Would your Holy Spirit guide us and instruct us and teach us, Lord, how we can awaken ourselves to that which you are trying to show us. We pray this in your name. Amen.
Well, we're going to continue our worship service with the giving of tithes and offering. So at this time, if you want to go ahead and make your way to anaheimfmc.org, you can follow the pages to the giving website. And for the rest of us, as you're here in this space, as you're responding to the invitation that Pastor Kevin gave, why don't we just go ahead and take a moment just to process that invitation, to see how we can make it real in our own lives. We'll do this for just a few moments, and when you're ready, we'll go ahead and come back and we'll sing one last song together. But let's give this time to the Lord. Well, if you're able to stand, I'm going to invite you to stand right now with me. We're going to close our service by singing the song Forever.
Thanks to the Lord, our God and King, His love endures forever. For He is good, He is above all things, His love endures forever. Sing praise, sing praise.
With a mighty hand,
with a mighty hand, and an outstretched arm, His love endures forever. For the life has been reborn, His love endures forever. Sing praise, sing praise,
sing praise,
sing praise, sing praise. Forever God is faithful, forever God is strong, forever God is with us, forever and ever, forever.
Sing from the rising to the setting sun.
From the rising to the setting sun, His love endures forever. Grace of God we will carry on, His love endures forever.
Sing praise.
Sing praise. Sing praise. Sing praise. Sing praise. Forever God is faithful. Forever God is strong. Forever God is with us, forever.
Sing that again, forever.
Forever God is faithful, forever God is strong. Forever God is with us, forever.
Sing, sing praise.
Sing praise. God is faithful, forever God is strong.
Sing it out.
Forever God is with us, forever.
One more time, congregation, sing with me.
Forever God is faithful, forever God is strong. God is with us forever and ever, forever.
With that, church, will you receive the benediction for this morning? Now may the Lord bless you, and may the Lord keep you. May the Lord make His face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. And may the Lord lift up His countenance upon you and give you His peace. For today, for tomorrow, and forevermore. Amen. Amen. Well, we pray that you have such a wonderful Mother's Day weekend. Will you go out from this place and celebrate the women in your life that has stirred you towards God, that have made your life better. We look forward to seeing you again next week.